Yeah. So she is not here, and we are going to continue looking at this question we were discussing last week, that if even an E2 or two linear equation, and this is a solution space for this system, then when we do E1 plus E2, like when we solve simultaneous equations, we add them, right? So what can we say about the solution space of E1, comma E1 plus E2? So we can continue looking at this, or we can leave this and maybe look at some questions from the puzzle board or something like that. Should we continue with this?
No problem. Yeah, we can continue with this.
Okay. I haven't had a chance to work on it during the week, so yeah.
Even I, yes, ma'am. Even I didn't.
So yeah, we would multiply and then subtract. Jagdish, sir, last week we are still discussing how to justify the way we solve systems of equations. I think you were there in the session before, right? Like, so this is the set of all ordered pairs XY. So this is the two equations in XY. So these are all the set of ordered pairs X1, Y1, which solve these equations. So if this is S1, and then if we add E1 plus E2, and that gives a solution space S2. I think last time we saw that S1 is a subset of S2. This much we saw. But
okay,
what is the relationship between this S2 and E1? And how is the solution space of this? We call it S3. What is this? We are yet to see.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Ma'am, there is a pattern actually. There is a pattern emerging, but
I can write it down if you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. I just tried with a few values of X and Y.
Okay.
Let's say for equation one, if you the solution space is X is equal to zero. If X is equal to zero, Y is 7/2.
Okay.
Y is 7/2. X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 4/2.
Okay.
And if X is equal to 2, Y is X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 4/2. 4/2 is 2 actually, but you can write 4/2, ma'am.
Sure. Yeah.
And X is equal to 2, just one more value. X is equal to 2, Y is equal to 1/2.
Okay.
So this is the solution space for equation 1.
Okay.
And if you consider equation 2 separately, for X is equal to 0, Y is equal to 4, X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 3. X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 3, and X is equal to Y is equal to 2.
Okay.
Now, for the solution space for E1 plus E2, it is...
Yeah.
Yeah. It is actually for X is equal to 0, X is equal to 0, the Y value is, I don't know, surprisingly, in 7/2, the numerator is 7, right?
Okay.
The numerator of y is equal to 7/2, the numerator is 7. And in equation 2, the numerator is 4. So if you add both the numerators, 7 plus 4 is 11. 4 is 11 divided by divided by, and denominator for e1 is 2. Denominator, if you come to y is equal to 7/2, right? In y is equal to 7/2, the denominator is 2, and in e2 the denominator is 1 because it is 4/1.
Okay.
So now add 7 + 4 and add 2 + 1.
Oh wow!
Separately.
Oh okay.
I don't know. This is strange. I mean, 7 / 11/3. So this is the actual solution. So for x is equal to 1 also, if you do the same thing, you'll get.
So y is equal to 4/2 + 3/1.
Now, ma'am, actually 4 + 3/2 + 1. It's not actually 4/2 + 3/1.
Right.
Yeah, add numerator separately, denominator separately. Yeah.
Right.
So it is 4 + 3. Three or 2 + 1, so which is 7/3.
Okay.
So similarly.
Okay.
Yeah. And similarly, you can get. I mean, x is equal to 2. It is x equal to 2. It is 1 + 2 divided by 2 + 1, which is 3/3. Yeah, 3/3, and so on.
Oh. Okay. Oh, interesting. There is some name for doing fractions this way. Some, I think, Faraday. Some name is there. Maybe this is a actual thing. I don't know. That's a nice pattern. No? Wow.
This is strange because we are not adding 7/2 and 4. 7/2 + 4 is different. It is not 11/3. Yeah. So what we are doing here is we are adding the numerator part and the denominator part separately.
And these don't occur in. Oh, okay. First, I think we need to have solution space of e1, e2. Also, we need to just. I take down. I think e1, comma
e1.
Sunil sir, if you look at the pattern.
Yes, sir.
Look at the pattern. Then first equation and equation and equation 2. Equation, yes, pattern will be -3 and -4 divided by 2. So, sir, E1 plus E2 pattern will be -4n/3, 4n - 3/3. Look at the pattern then. If you look at the pattern, 11 by 3, 7/3 + 1, 3/3. If you look at that, you get it. That is one of the, I think it is a negative one of the polygon. I think it is a polygonal number. I feel that is 3n - 4 divided by 2, 4n - 3 by.
Sir, can you repeat, sir? I did not understand, actually.
No. You said no, that is 7/2. Equation 1, the 7/2 + 4/2 + half is equal to, if you continue the pattern, that is -3 and -4 divided by 2. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then if you continue the second, E1 plus equation 2, equation 1, equation 2, the pattern will be -4 and -3 divided by 3.
Okay.
Look at the, so if you consider that equation 3 again, suppose there will be another equation, it may be another same repetition, that is -5 and -2 divided by 4 or something, you may get it. I
by observation, I think solution space of solution space of E1, comma E2 is equal to solution space of E1 plus comma E1, and also it is the same as solution space of E1 plus E2 comma E2. So if we try to solve 4x plus 3y and x plus y will give the same. Or if we solve fx plus, sorry, 4x plus 3y equal to 11 and cx plus 2y equal to 7, that will also give the same. So it seems like it is equal, but why, how?
Let me see, is it true for all linear equations?
It seems to be, because that is what we are using to solve simultaneous equations. So we add, then we get a value for one of the variables, which we replace back into one of the previous equations and get the value for the second variable. So that is equivalent to solving the system of equations E1 plus E2 and E1. It is the same. So it seems to be holding, but that's what justification we are not getting. Like that day we did for multiplying both sides of the equation by a constant. So for that, we gave that justification of every solution in this set has to be there and converge also. So that kind of logic, I'm unable to come up with for this. What is E1 plus E2? How to even characterize that as a solution set? I'm not able to.
You've taken sum of the two equations. If it is subtraction, means what is it?
Subtraction is the same as multiply by one and then add, right? So multiply by one, we have said it doesn't change the solution space. Okay. So if we look at addition, it surprises addition. Yeah, I think I was able to work that out the same way. It's the same thing, like we solve the equation, but because it's values at that point, we can do any manipulation we want. So if we have E1 is CX plus 2y equal to 7, E2 is x plus y equal to 4, and the solution space of this is S1. So if we add this, E1 plus E2 gives us 4x plus 3y equal to 11. So if you look at solution space of E1 and this, let's call it S3. So for any X1, Y1 that belongs to S1, we have to show that it also belongs to also belongs to S3, and converse if there is any X2, Y2 belonging to S3, X2, Y2 also belongs to S1. So this we can do by just using x1, y1 instead of xy in E3x. So once we have x1, y1, we can do these adding and subtracting and all. We are dealing with a value. So we can show. So this one, right? First to prove this. So if there's an x1, y1 in S1, then it holds, x1, y1 is a solution for this. And that is already a part here. So that part is proven. So what we have to show is that it also solves this equation. So that we can easily show by, so 3x1 plus 2y1 is equal to 7 will be true. As also x1 plus y1 equal to 4 will be true, because x1, y1 belongs to S1. So that means it's a solution for both these. Now these are values, so we can easily add. So this will give us 4x1 plus 3y1 is equal to 11, which proves that x1, y1 belongs to S3. It's a solution for, we know it's already a solution for E, but it's also a solution for E1 plus E2 because 4x1 plus 3y1 equal to 11. So it will belong to S3. Same logic, we can show that any x2, y2 belonging to x3 will also belong to S1. So S3 okay. Equal to S1. So which is why our way of solving simultaneous equations is valid.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.